In today's video, I'm gonna show how you can get another rare summon spirit in Elden Ring. I am talking about this maiden that's gonna heal you a lot, probably the best heal from a summon spirit that you can get in Elden Ring. And this is not the easiest thing to get, but trust me, you're gonna thank me later, because in certain situation you're gonna need a healing something like this healing summon spirit. Now, first things first, make your way to the Rani's Rise. If you don't know how to get there, I have a video of exactly how you can be there. And then after, you're gonna talk with her up there in the rise. You will have to go here to talk with this spirit. This is the spirit of Selvius. Okay, I never know the names, how to pronounce those names. But after, you're gonna discuss with him, the next step it will be for us to go in his rise. I'm gonna show you for the first time how you can get there from the Rani's Rise, Selvius Rise, how you can be there. And then every single time when I'm gonna go back to him, I'm just gonna teleport him. So now you have to learn the way. From the from this site of grace, from the Rani site of grace, all you have to do is to go on the right. Don't have to defeat that dragon and talk with him. It's gonna give you a task that you have to do, but I'm gonna explain what are your options and how you can get those puppets, this maiden puppet, because it's, yeah, the name of this summon spirit, it's puppet maiden, or yeah, in the name there is a name to that maiden that I never know how to pronounce. Then you're gonna get this Selvius potion. He will tell you to give her to Nephelis, but you will not do this thing unless you want to get the Nephelis puppet, but you're gonna ruin the Nephelis questline. Also, you have the option to give this potion to Dungeater, and you're gonna get another puppet, the Dungeater puppet. But again, if you do that, you're gonna ruin the Dungeater questline. And for me, the best way of how you can use this potion is to give it here to Gideon. This is the Nephelis father. Basically, in this way, I'm gonna complete all three quest line: Nephelis, Selvius, and the Dungeater quest. This is for me the best option. And I will not get in this gameplay, in this new game plus, I will not get the Dungeater puppet and Nephelis, but I don't care about that. We are here to discuss about that maiden summon spirit that you can get from this NPC, from the Selvius. Now, after you're gonna give that to someone, you'll come back to him and you'll have to tell him that you did the job. And then you'll have two discussion. You can buy sorceries from this wizard. I don't even know what is this guy. Probably it's a wizard. But you'll see two different discussion. After you're gonna complete every single discussion, then you have to reach to the Selvius chambers. And then those chambers are something secret. Go to the Rani's Rise, right over here on the map. Go again, and go a little bit on the left. You'll see those wolves, and you'll see a secret ceiling that you can just jump or roll over that, and it will disappear. This one. Now here, jump or roll, and you're gonna reveal this secret door. There will be an enemy right there, but you don't have trouble with that. Just go down. And these are the secret chambers of Selvius. Here you'll have to read the message from this area. The message will be right over here. And then we have to go back to Selvius and discuss with him, and told him that we just discovered the chambers and we are on the right path right now. This is another secret room that you can discover. I just wanted to show you that. And now let's see what Selvius have to say about the chambers. And this is very, very important, because basically now you're gonna tell him about the chambers. Okay, you're gonna get this discussion, but it's a very important one. Let me explain why. Because now you'll be able to get a puppet, your own puppet. And you'll have two choices, the maiden or the jarhead puppet. I decided for first game to take the maiden, but also in this video, really fast, I'm gonna show how you can get also the second puppet, the finger maiden Teorolia. Okay, I don't know how to pronounce it, I don't know how to read that name. But really, really fast, let me explain how you can get also the second puppet. All you have to do is to take a shard, a starlight shard, from this location, if you don't have one already. But if you have one already, you just have to give that shard to him. But let me tell you, if you'll have any trouble to get a second puppet, even if you have this shard that I'm going to show you right now how you can get it from this location, even if you have this and it will not work, just go ahead once and use the puppet that you just bought. You use the maiden puppet in a random area where you can use that, and then just go back with him at him and talk with him, and you're gonna get the second puppet, which will be that jar. But I'm gonna show you right now in 1 second, after I'm gonna take this shard. I want a new puppet, you're gonna tell him, and you can take. You can choose between the puppet that those two that it has, he has, and I'm gonna make a video to showcase you the second one and to show you how that works. But I have to upgrade it now. I don't have it upgraded. Definitely, I have to upgrade that puppet to show you how it works. It's a different one. I don't know which one is better, but in this video I'm gonna discuss of what you can do with that maiden puppet, because that now you got it. And now let me explain how you can use it. Most of the people don't know. This is the way I can take the second one. Okay, most of the people don't know, but this maiden, beside the fact that it can heal you, it has also some attack. What damage it will throw with something on your enemies. These are the stats that you are seeing right now. Let's spawn the puppet. Finger maiden Terolina. Terolina. Okay. A pretty ugly name. Now let me show you how that this maiden will work. How this summon spirit will work. If you are in the area where that where she will cast the spell, if you are in that certain area near her right here, you're gonna get your life back. Yep, basically it has a heal, a very, very good heal. Imagine what you can do with some enemies if you have this on your side. Trust me, it's gonna be with certain bosses you're gonna need this heal. Also, it can do some damage, I told you. Probably not the best damage, but definitely it can do some damage to your enemies. Now, this is the only way, in my opinion, of how you can get that puppet. This, or probably, I'm not 100% sure, if you will kill Seluvis, you can get his bell bearing, but you're gonna ruin every single side quest. I'm not recommend you to do that. Probably you can get the puppet in that way, but I'm not recommend you to do that. Thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button, subscribe, share, and I'm gonna see you in the next one. Be safe. Bye.